WatchOS 6.1 has been released quite some time ago, a couple of months actually, but if you buy the Apple Watch Series 5 right now, out of the box, you have the WatchOS 6, and 6.1 is the first software update to install. So how does it run on this device? Well, it's kind of important to know because there aren't any new features or anything that would really change the way the Apple Watch works, or looks, or feels. I mean, it's only described as bug fixes, and one important add-on or one important thing is that there is a support for the AirPods Pro. I mean, does that mean that you wouldn't be able to use them without the 6.1? Of course not. But if you, for example, don't run the certain version of iOS or even macOS, the AirPods Pro don't show up the way they would show up on that updated version of your device. For example, on my not updated Mac, you can see they still look like a speaker, not like AirPods. The same thing happened on the iPhone, where if you connect them, you can literally see the logo of the AirPods Pro in the menu or the volume bar. So they made some refinements to make sure that the AirPods Pro work better. They may connect faster and stuff, but overall, it's not something that would prevent you from using the AirPods Pro without this new version. One very interesting thing that I noticed while updating my Apple Watch was that you can see on the phone right here that the capacity of my Apple Watch back then, running WatchOS 6, everything you can see right there was 26.2 gigabytes with the available storage of 22.4. So yeah, the amount of photos, videos, apps, everything, of course songs, there's no way to get videos to the Apple Watch, but it's completely the same, and like I said, the capacity is 25.2, and running 6.1, it jumped to 26.9, as well as the available storage of 24.3. So you can actually see that there's a difference, like 22.4 compared to 24.3, it's almost 2 gigs of storage that got back, and it's quite a lot, to be honest. So it's actually kind of cool that we get the amount of storage back, but of course, on the Apple Watch, it's not that noticeable. Like, many people don't really just browse their storage and have exactly or know exactly how much storage they have left on their Apple Watch, but yeah, it's definitely a way to go for Apple. Another feature or something that they described in the update was that the support for WatchOS 6 comes to other devices, namely Apple Watch Series 1 and 2. So we can see right there the WatchOS 6.1 is already now available, whereas the WatchOS 6 was not. So yeah, but a specific dedicated video about that later, so make sure you subscribe. So like I said, there aren't any specific features described in the software update description, or is that anything that you would notice, except for the support for the AirPods, like I said, the AirPods Pro, of course. But for me, what I've noticed running the WatchOS 6 out of the box on the Series 5 was that in this homepage, I just didn't have the option to swipe up on the control center all the time. It wouldn't simply react to my touch. I mean, for some reason, it just simply did not work 100% of the time, and maybe like 70% of the time, and 3 out of 10 times, it just didn't react when I swiped up like that, and you can see now it works. So I guess that some of the bug fixes are real, and there are some things that wouldn't really work that well back then, and now it's a lot smoother, and I think it works a little bit better. So definitely, if you have like bought the brand new Apple Watch and you get immediately pop up to update to your Apple Watch and you think like, why should I do it? I've just got it. I've just unboxed it. Just go ahead and do it. Usually the first version that the phone or device comes with is probably not the best one. So make sure to update to 6.1 because you're going to feel the difference in terms of the speed and everything. It just runs a little bit better in my opinion. So like I said, it's not about the features. It's about the speed and performance. Bug fixes, the support for the AirPods. Older generations are supported as well. Like I already mentioned, the update has been released at the end of October, like in the beginning of November, I believe. So it's not a brand new update, but there are people like me just who got the brand new Apple Watch and immediately get the pop-up with the 6.1 being available. So that's why I decided to make this video, show you guys how it actually feels, how it runs on the brand new Apple Watch, and it's gonna be followed by the old Apple Watch, like I said. So make sure you subscribe and do not miss it. See you guys later in the next one. It's been Lucas from Apple Fox, and see you guys later in the next video. Peace out.